So Bernie, this is your second painting exhibition. How is it different from the last?
This time I decided to put on canvas all the nighttime events that I had personally witnessed when I was doing my research.
So, research as a sociologist?
Yeah, research as a sociologist. I was studying all these events, festivals from the anthropological point of view. So since I liked drawing and coloring, and since the memories of these events, nighttime events, were so colorfully ingrained in my mind, I thought I should put them on canvas before my own memory fades away, and at least the future generation might be able to see it. Because yeah, some of them may not be performed 20 years hence or 25 years hence.
What are the subjects like, for instance?
They include just labor activities, like for instance parboiling paddy at night.
This one? This one?
And the feti also. But feti is, it has a dual kind of purpose.
Feti in the sense that they are pounding rice?
Feti is they are pounding rice into puffed rice. But this particular one is done in honor of the ancestors. So it is. It has a dual purpose. It's a ceremony, and at the same time it's part of their labor cycle also. But parboiling paddy at night, that is like a labor activity, but it's done at night because that's the time when the sun dies down and it's cool too. But it's very much a part of social life of Goa because people tell stories at that time, so you know, children get to learn stories and things like that.
So you're looking at these works from two angles, as a sociologist and as an artist?
Yes, as an artist.
But and they're two different worlds?
They're two different worlds, but I think this is like an interface because here I have just tried to capture one moment of whatever happens.
Yeah.
And when I write, it's like you write the entire event, you explain the whole event.
There is a conflict in that sense. Here you are letting your heart respond.
Yes, because this is like, you know, the intellectual part really doesn't come over anything else. It's more the colors and yeah, the whole atmosphere that I want to kind of recreate.
Which communities does it touch on? Mostly Aboriginal communities of Goa?
It cuts across all communities. Aboriginal, Hindus, Christians, everybody who lives Goa.
For instance,
could be like this particular painting, the Feti, the one that I witnessed, was performed by the Kunbi community.
Yeah.
Dalu are performed by mainly agricultural communities, all communities who are involved in cultivation of rice paddy. Saibin, of course, is cuts across all sections of society, the Christians. And Zagur, for instance, why I painted this Sioli.
Zagur is cross-religious.
It is, yes. Both Hindus and Christians in Sioli area celebrate Zagur. So that is what I want to, like, you know, highlight. That.
What are you saying as an artist and as a sociologist? There's a different message. As an artist, I guess you're preserving it. As a sociologist, you're explaining it?
As a sociologist, I mean, mere explanation or mere description doesn't make sociology. You have to, I think everybody looks for a viewpoint. But in my art, I think I'm just happy if the future generation looks and understands that their forefathers lived in a different way. That's all. I mean, yeah, I can't really push a message on to the next generation.
At least two persons were upset that you are not planning to sell these exhibits.
Okay. What I thought was the main purpose of the paintings is that they should reach an audience as wide as possible. So there were many people asking me for prints.
Yeah.
And I thought that is a good way of the paintings reaching a very wide number of people, cutting across sections, even class sections. So although people have been saying that the value of the originals will go down, but it really doesn't matter to me. Because I think with prints, more number of people will get the painting.
Thank you.
That is the message.
Thank you and all the best.
Thanks.